Very good afternoon, students. In the previous session, we have seen the two reference electrodes. What are the remaining two reference electrodes? One was the quinhydrone electrode and another was the glass electrode. But in all the electrodes, in all the reference electrodes, we have used one equation. What is that equation? That equation is a Nernst equation. Nernst equation is very, very important in the external examination for long answer question. So today I'm going to explain you the Nernst equation. What is the expression of the Nernst equation? Nernst equation at room temperature. Here room temperature is 25 degrees centigrade. And derivation of Nernst equation. Determining equilibrium constant. There I explained K. What is K there? K was the equilibrium constant, which was the product's concentration divided by reactant's concentration. So today I'm going to explain you the equilibrium constant also, applications of Nernst equation and solid examples. In this, I'm going to explain you one or two numericals. What is Nernst equation? What you have seen in the Nernst equation, E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT by NF log K. That we have seen in the Nernst equation, E is equals to E naught. What is E? E is nothing but the electrode potential. What is E naught? E naught is the standard electrode potential. What is K? Equilibrium constant. In the place of K, we can write even Q also. Q is nothing but the reaction quotient. That reaction quotient is converts to K when the reaction reaches the equilibrium. Yes, when the reaction reaches the equilibrium, Q is equals to K. So what is the relationship in the Nernst equation? The relation between E and K or E and Q. Yes, that is the Nernst equation. The Nernst equation provides a relation between the cell potential. Cell potential means nothing but E cell. Cell potential of an electrochemical cell, the standard cell potential, that is E naught, temperature T, and the reaction quotient Q. Yes, this is a relation between the electrode potential, that is a cell potential, standard cell potential, temperature, and the reaction quotient. That is called the Nernst equation. Even under non-standard conditions, the cell potential of electrochemical cell can be determined with the help of the Nernst equation. Yes. So even at the non-standard conditions, standard conditions are nothing but the room temperature and the atmospheric pressure. If we don't know the temperature and the pressure, also we can find the electrode potential by using Nernst equation. That means we can calculate E value. We can calculate E value even by even if we not knowing the temperature and the pressure. That is the main aim of the Nernst equation. The Nernst equation is often used to calculate the cell potential of an electrochemical cell at a given temperature, pressure, and the reaction concentration. Yes, so we can find the cell potential of an electrochemical cell at the given temperature, pressure, and the reaction concentration. The equation was introduced by the German chemist. The name of this scientist is Walther Hermann Nernst. He has introduced a Nernst equation, but what is the use of Nernst equation? Nernst equation is using to find the cell potential or the electrode potential at a given temperature and the pressure and the reaction concentration. This is the main aim of the Nernst equation. Now let us see the expression of the Nernst equation. After seeing the expression, let us see the Nernst equation at room temperature also. Derivation of Nernst equation. Consider a metal which is in contact with own salt aqueous solution. So just let us assume here metal is dipping in its own salt solution. That means metal is dipping in the MX solution, or zinc is dipping in the zinc sulfate, copper is dipping in the copper sulfate. That means metal is dipping in its own salt solution. reactions of metal losing an electron to become an ion and the ion gaining electron to return the atomic state are equally feasible and are in equilibrium state. So what is happening here when the metal is dipping in its own salt solution, metal is having the tendency to lose the electrons. When the metal is losing the electrons, we will get the ion. Again, ion is gaining the electrons to convert to the atomic state. Yes. So these two are having the same feasibility. Metal to metal ion to metal. These two conversions are having the same feasibility. So it reaches the equilibrium. This is a reaction. We are taking the reduction reaction here. In the reduction reaction, ion is gaining the electrons to convert to metal. In the backward reaction, what is happening? Metal is losing n number of electrons to produce Mn plus. In the forward reaction, Mn plus is having n number of electrons deficiency. The charge will be deficiency. If we have 1 plus, it is having 1 electron deficiency. If it is having 2 plus, it is having 2 electron deficiency. If we have 3 plus, 3 electrons deficiency. But here in this reaction, the metal is having n number of electrons deficiency. So it is gaining n number of electrons to convert to the neutral metal, neutral atom, Nm. So let us derive the Nernst equation to this particular reaction. In the reduction reaction, n moles of an electron is taken up by an ion against a reduction potential of E reduction. Yes, so when the metal ion is gaining n number of electrons to give the atom or to give the metal, it is having a particular reduction potential that is assumed as a E reduction. The work done in the movement of electron. So here, when the electron is gaining, it is doing some work. It is doing some work. That work done is assumed as a W red. W red is nothing but reduction potential work done. Reduction potential work done is equals to NF E reduction. This is the formula. This is the formula. This is the bridge relationship between thermodynamics and the electrochemistry. W red is equals to NF E red. What is W red? W red is a work done for the reduction potential. What is N? Number of electrons. F is a Faraday constant and E red is a reduction potential. So here what is F? F is a Faraday. That value is 96,487 coulombs, which is defined as the electrical charge carried by one mole of electrons. The charge, whatever the charge is carrying for the one mole of electron, that is equals to one Faraday. So one Faraday value is 96,487 coulombs. So we got one reaction, we got one equation. What is that equation? W red is equals to NF E red. That is the maximum work done for the reduction potential. Now, change in the Gibbs free energy is an indication of the spontaneity and it is equal to the maximum useful work done in a process. So here, this is from the thermodynamics. Change in the Gibbs free energy is equals to maximum work done. Already we have seen the work done, but here, that maximum work done is equals to change in the Gibbs free energy from thermodynamics. So from the first reaction, we got W red is equals to NF E red. But what is maximum work done? I said now the maximum work done is equals to change in the Gibbs free energy. Change symbol is delta, delta G. But for the maximum work done, the change in the Gibbs free energy will be negative. So we are having minus delta G. So we can write NF E red is equals to minus delta G. And finally, we can write delta G is equals to minus NF E red. Because when we are taking this minus N minus here, We can write delta G is equals to minus NF E red. Let us assume this as equation 1. So we got delta G is equals to minus NF E red. Change in the Gibbs free energy at standard conditions. We need even at the standard conditions also. For the standard conditions, generally we are mentioning E naught, delta G naught, because we know the conditions. What are the standard conditions? Standard conditions are room temperature and the atmospheric pressure. So change in the Gibbs free energy at standard conditions. What are the standard conditions here? Room temperature. What is the room temperature? 25 degrees centigrade is the room temperature. But we need capital T. That means we need the temperature in Kelvin. How to convert temperature from degree centigrade to Kelvin? By adding 273. If you add 273 to the degree centigrade value, we will get in the Kelvin. We will get the temperature in Kelvin. So 25 plus 273, how much you will get? You will get 298 Kelvin. And 1 molar atmospheric pressure or 1 molar concentration or 1 atmospheric pressure conditions is called delta G naught. These are the standard conditions. At the standard conditions, generally we are mentioning naught. From the above relation, it can be written that we know delta G is equals to minus NFE. Yes, we know delta G is equals to minus NFE. So same we can apply at the standard conditions. That means we can write delta G naught. So delta G naught is equals to minus NF. We should not write N naught, F naught, E. We can write E naught because E is a variable. But N and F are not variables here. N and F are constants. So delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught. So we have written, we have applied. So we have written finally delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught red. So one, what is E naught red? Electrode potential at the standard conditions. Now during the reaction, concentration keeps changing and the potential also will decrease with the rate of reaction. Yes, when the reaction is progresses, when the reaction is going on, the concentration of the solution is changing and also the potential will be decreasing. So to get the maximum work or maximum free energy change, the concentration have to be maintained same. Because when the concentration is changing, what is happening here? The potential is decreasing. But we must get the maximum work done. To get the maximum work done, what we have to do? We have to maintain the concentration constant. That means constant concentration. So this is possible only by carrying out the reaction under a reversible equilibrium condition. That means when we maintain the equilibrium conditions, then only we can maintain the concentration as a constant. So for a reversible equilibrium reaction, want of isotherm. That means it is at the standard conditions and at the constant concentration. We got one relation from thermodynamics. You have to remember this. Delta G is equals to delta G naught plus RT ln K. This we got from want of isotherm at the constant concentration. So what we got? Delta G is equals to delta G naught plus RT ln K. But already we know what is delta G and delta G naught. What is delta G? Delta G is equals to minus NFE. What is delta G naught? Minus NF E naught. So let us substitute in the place of delta G and delta G naught as NFE, NF E naught minus. But what is K here? It is the equilibrium constant. What is the equilibrium constant? Product concentration divided by reactants concentration. R is the gas constant. Always it is constant, that is 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole. And T is the temperature in Kelvin. So let us substitute the free energy changes in the half equation, want of equation. So minus NFE is equals to minus NFE naught plus RT ln. What is K here? In our reaction, product is M and reactant is Mn plus. What is the product? NM is a product. NM is a product. But I said in yesterday's class that the number of moles must be on the power. So we are writing m power n divided by mn plus m. Now let us divide both sides with minus nf. When we divide both sides with minus nf e divided by minus nf. So minus nf will cancel. So we will get e red is equals to minus nf e naught divided by minus nf. Minus nf will cancel. We will get e naught red plus rt by minus nf. Rt by minus nf means we can write in the plus into minus minus rt by nf log this value. But here ln is nothing but 2.303 log. In the place of ln, we can write 2.303 log. This is only the Nernst equation. E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT by NF log K. What is K? Products concentration divided by reactants concentration. But I said in the yesterday's class that always solid concentration is equals to 1. We know that metal is a solid. Solid concentration is equals to 1. So in the place of m power n, we can write 1. Because metal is a solid, its concentration is equals to 1. So 1 divided by mn plus. Because here, metal concentration is equals to 1. This relation connecting reduction potential measured at conditions other than standard conditions. This Nernst equation is using for other than standard conditions. So this is about the Nernst equation derivation. So simple, we have only 4 steps. In the first step, we got the maximum work done. The maximum work done is equals to NF E red. And after that, from thermodynamics, we know that maximum work done is equals to change in the Gibbs free energy, which is negative. So we got delta G is equals to minus NF E red. So when we are applying this reaction at the standard conditions, what we got, delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught red. But I said, I explained now that here the reduction potential value is decreasing by changing the concentration. Because when the concentration is changing in the reaction process, the work done is decreasing and the change in the Gibbs free energy is decreasing and potential value also decreases. But our aim is we must get the maximum work done. So we are maintaining the constant concentration. At the constant concentration, we got one relation, that is delta G is equals to delta G naught plus RT ln K. When we substitute delta G and delta G naught in this reaction or in this formula, we got finally E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT by NF log K. K is products concentration divided by reactants concentration. So now let us see the Nernst equation at room temperature. But I said now, what is the room temperature? Room temperature is 25 degrees centigrade. But we need the temperature in Kelvin. To convert degree centigrade to Kelvin, what we have to do? We have to add 273. So we got 298 Kelvin. So for measurements carried out at 298 Kelvin, the Nernst equation can be expressed as follows. At Nernst equation, we are substituting R value as 8.314, T value as 298 Kelvin, F value, that is the Faraday constant, 96,487. By substituting these three values, we know R value, T value, F value. By substituting these three values, what we got the Nernst equation at room temperature, that is equals to E naught minus 0.059 by N log Q. So what is Q here? Q is a reaction quotient, which is products concentration divided by reactants concentration. Therefore, as per the Nernst equation, the overall potential of an electrochemical cell is dependent on the reaction quotient. E is depending on Q. From this reaction, we can tell that electrode potential is depending on the reaction quotient in the Nernst equation. So for reaction conducted at 298 Kelvin, but at concentration, Nernst equation is, so we are substituting. I said now, R value 8.314, T value 298 Kelvin, F value 96,487. So we got this last equation at room temperature, that is E red is equals to E naught red minus 0.059 by N log Q. What is Q here? Product concentration divided by reactant concentration. This is the last equation at room temperature. So now let us see the reaction quotient. So what is reaction quotient? It is the ratio of product concentration and the reactants concentration. It is defined as the ratio of products and reactants concentration. So Q can be written as products concentration divided by reactants concentration. So let us see some examples to how to write the Q value for the particular reactions. So let us assume, let us take one reaction. AA is giving rise to BB. This is one of the best example. In this example, we have only one reactant and the one product. But here, small A moles of capital A reactant, small B moles of capital B product is there. Always the number of moles must be on the power. But what is reaction quotient? Product's concentration divided by reactant concentration. What is product here? B is a product. A is a reactant. Capital letters are reactants and the product. But number of moles must be on the power. So B power B divided by A power A. That is Q for the one reactant and one product. But if we have the multiple reactants and the products, the reaction quotient writing is different. So let us see here in this example, we have two reactants and the two products. Small A moles of capital A, small B moles of capital B reactants are giving small C moles of capital C, small D moles of capital D reactants. What are the products here? Capital C, capital D are products. Capital A, capital B are reactants. In the place of plus, we are going to write the multiplication symbol. In the place of plus, we are going to write the multiplication symbol. The number of moles must be on the power. The number of moles must be on the power. So let us write Q here. Q is equals to C power C into D power D. See here, C power C into D power D divided by A power A into B power B. That is the reaction quotient for the one reactant or the multiple reactants and the products. Now, determination of equilibrium constant with Nernst equation. I said now, when the reaction reaches equilibrium, Q will equals to K. Q is equals to K when the reactants and products are reaching the equilibrium state. So, determination of equilibrium constant with Nernst equation. When the reactants and the products of the electrochemical cell reaction reaches equilibrium, the value of delta G becomes zero. When the reaction reaches equilibrium, the maximum work done will be equals to zero. That means delta G is equals to zero at the equilibrium condition. At this point, the reaction quotient and the reaction constant are same. So at what condition? At the equilibrium condition, at the equilibrium state, the reaction quotient and the equilibrium constant, these two will be equal. That means Q is equals to K at equilibrium. So since delta G is equals to minus NFE, but I said now delta G is equals to zero. If delta G is equals to zero, E will be equals to zero. So let us substitute that value in the Nernst equation. When we substitute that, substituting the values of Q and E in the Nernst equation. So what is Nernst equation? E is equals to E naught minus RT by NF ln K. Or in the place of ln, we can write 2.303 log, whatever we can write here. But here E cell is equals to zero at equilibrium conditions. When we substitute in the place of E cell is equals to zero, we got zero is equals to E naught cell minus RT by NF ln K. The relation between the Nernst equation The equilibrium constant and Gibbs free energy change is illustrated below. So only this much more. So we got E naught cell is equals to RT by NF ln K. So finally we got E naught cell is equals to RT by NF ln K. This is the equilibrium constant at the equilibrium conditions. So now let us see the applications of Nernst equation. What are the applications where we are using the Nernst equation? The Nernst equation can be used to calculate the single electrode reduction or oxidation at any conditions. So we can find the reduction potentials as well as the oxidation potential. That means E-red or E-ox. Now we have seen E-red. That is the reduction potential. Even we can find E-ox also. That means oxidation potential also by using the Nernst equation. Standard electrode potentials. That means E-naught values also we can find by using the Nernst equation. Comparing the relative ability as a reductive or oxidative agent. Finding the feasibility of the combination of such single electrode to produce electrode potential. EMF of an electrochemical cell. Even we can find the EMF also. What is EMF? E cathode minus E anode. If you are finding E cathode separately, E anode separately, can't we find E cell? That is EMF. We can find by substituting in the EMF formula. Unknown ionic concentration. Even unknown ionic solution concentration also we can find by using the Nernst equation. And also we can find the pH of solutions and solubility of sparingly soluble salts can be measured with the help of the Nernst equation. These are the best applications of the Nernst equation. So now let us see the numericals based on the Nernst equation. So I'll explain one numerical now. Remaining will be same. The standard electrode potential of zinc ion is 0.76 volts. Then what will be the potential of a 2 molar solution at 300 Kelvin? So what they are asking, what will be the potential? Potential is nothing but E. We need to calculate E. They have given E naught and also they have given the concentration and also given the temperature. If we know all the values, can't we find the E cell by applying in the Nernst equation or by substituting in the Nernst equation? What is the Nernst equation? E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT by NF log K. Yes, that is the Nernst equation. But in the place of K, what we have written? 1 divided by Mn plus concentration. So let us see the Nernst equation. E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT by NF log 1 by Mn plus. Now we need to calculate E. They have given E naught. What is E naught? Standard electrode potential. What is the standard electrode potential given in the numerical? 0.76. So in the place of E naught, let us write 0.76. But we know the R value always constant, that is 8.314. T given in the numerical, T is absolute temperature in Kelvin, that is 300 Kelvin. Number of electrons. The zinc can lose the 2 electrons or zinc can gain the 2 electrons. So the number of electrons will be 2. So N will be 2. F is a Faraday constant, always it is constant. That is 96,487. And they have given the Mn plus solution concentration. What is Mn plus solution concentration? 2 molar. So let us substitute all the values. E naught is 0.76, R is 8.314, T is 300 in Kelvin, N is 2, F is 96,487, Mn plus is the 2 molar. So if we substitute all the values, we will get the E value. E is the electrode potential. So same like this, we will be having the numericals. Remaining we'll see in the next class. Even the next topic also very, very important. That is determination of pH by using Quinn hydrogen electrode. So with this, I'm going to complete today's session. But everyone maintain the running notes now, because I'm going to check the running notes in the next week. Yes. Thank you so much.